Good morning. Billy, could you please read the problem, and Bo, could you please translate?
Flippin' physics.
A shopper pushes a shopping cart with a force of 6.9 newtons at an angle of 59 degrees to the left of the negative y-axis.
Stop. The force applied is 6.9 newtons at an angle of 59 degrees to the left of the negative y-axis.
Billy, please continue.
While the cart moves a horizontal distance of 7.0 meters, what is the work done by the shopper on the shopping cart?
Displacement equals 7.0 meters and work equals question mark.
I don't really understand the direction, the 59 degrees to the left of the negative y-axis. Could you please explain that?
Sure, Bobby. Let's take a look at the example to better understand what is going on here. You could see the 7 meters through which the cart travels. Also, in order to get actual numbers here for this force, I used a force sensor to measure that 6.9 newton force. And as far as the angle is concerned, you can see the force I am applying is down and to the left, and the 59 degree angle which I measured is between the force applied and the vertical. Bobby, does that help?
Yes, thank you. But doesn't that mean the cart is moving to the left, so the displacement of the cart should be negative 7 meters?
That is correct, Bobby. We also need a subscript on work because we always need to identify which force is or what forces are doing the work. Billy?
Well, it asks for the work the shopper does on the cart, and the shopper applies a force on the cart, so we're trying to determine the work done by the force applied.
This problem deals with forces, so Bo, what should we do next?
Draw the free body diagram.
Bo, why don't you do that?
Okay, the force applied is at an angle of 59 degrees to the left of the negative y-axis. The force of gravity is straight down, the force normal is straight up, and the force of friction is parallel to the ground and opposite the direction the cart is moving, so the force of friction is to the right. So now we need to break the force applied into its components.
Hold up, Bo, just wait a minute, please. When I first introduced free body diagrams, I said we usually break forces into components. Well, the work equation is an example of when we do not need to break forces into components, usually, because the angle is in the equation for work. Speaking of the equation for work, Bobby, could you please give us the work equation?
Work equals force times displacement times cosine theta.
Notice I added subscripts for the force applied because we are solving for the work done by the force applied. Billy, could you please substitute in values?
The force applied is 6.9 times the displacement, which is negative 7, times the angle theta, which is 59 degrees, times the cosine of 59 degrees, which is negative 24.876 newton meters, or with sig figs, negative 25 joules. Oh, wait a minute. We only use the magnitude of the force and the magnitude of the displacement in the work equation. So while the displacement is negative 7 meters, we actually need to use positive 7 meters in the equation.
Right. It's the cosine of the angle that determines if the work is positive or negative.
Yeah, speaking of the angle, we use the wrong value. Theta is the angle between the direction of the force applied and the displacement of the cart, which is actually, in this case, 90 minus 59 degrees, or 31 degrees, which means the work done by the force applied is actually 41.401, or with two sig figs, 41 newtons. I'm sorry, 41 joules.
Glad you all figured that out. Those are actually two very common mistakes students make with problems like this. Okay, there's actually more we can do with this problem. We can figure out the work done on the cart by the force of gravity. Bo?
Well, we can substitute in mass times the acceleration due to gravity for the force of gravity. However, we don't know the mass of the cart. Oh, but the force of gravity is straight down, and the displacement of the cart is to the left. The angle between those two directions is 90 degrees, and the cosine of 90 degrees is zero. So the work done by the force of gravity is zero.
Very nice, Bo. We can also figure out the work done on the cart by the force normal. Bobby?
Well, the force normal is up, and the cart is displaced to the left. Again, the angle between those two directions is 90 degrees, and the cosine of 90 degrees is zero. So the work done by the force normal on the cart is zero, just like the work done by the force of gravity.
Thank you, Bobby. Now, sadly, because we don't know the mass or the acceleration of the cart, we cannot figure out the work done on the cart by the force of friction. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.